Good morning, class. Sorry for the delay because of
Good
network
morning, sir.
was not able to connect with you. Okay, 9 minutes we are in loss. Okay, let's start our class. People are still joining. Okay, so today's topic is the structure of operating system. In previous class, we have studied dual mode of operating system and system call, I think, right? Please confirm me. Last class we have studied dual mode of operating system and system call, right? Please write in the
Yes,
chat
sir.
box.
Yes,
Okay.
sir.
Okay. So then we will start with the structures of different type of operating system. What are the different structures? Like simple structure, we have layered structure, then macro kernel structure are also there. So we will start today's class from. Okay. Okay. So today's topic is structures of operating system. Our first one is a simple structure. First one is simple structure. How simple structure is designed? Let's see. In simple structure, it does not break the system into subsystems. That is, it has no distinction between user and kernel modes, or allowing all programs direct access to the underlying hardware. Think about the analogy which I told you previously in previous classes. Like each and every student for each and every requirement and need, whether it is essential or non-essential, can approach to Dean of Faculty of Engineering, right? So in this manner, there is no intermediate layers are there. Means whatever your problem is directly listened by the dean of the faculty. And dean is one who is the resource allocator, who is a control program, who can manage each and everything of the users, that is students. Means you can have fast resolution of your problems, right? When you have direct access to the coordinator's office. Right, so this is that simple structure. Means each and every user program, like application programs, can directly access to the hardware. So this is the simple structure. Let's see how it works. As we can see, we are having application programs that can directly interact with the resident system program, MS-DOS device drivers, and the ROM BIOS device drivers. And you can see here that we are having a direct link also from application program to the device driver. Means application programs can directly interact with the hardware. This is the MS-DOS layer structure, Microsoft Disk Operating System, a simple structure of an operating system in which no intermediate layers are there, no kernel is there, no micro kernel is there. Each and every application program can directly interact with the device drivers, that is hardwares. So I am repeating how a simple structure works. It does not break the system into subsystems. Means we are having only a single program, only a single system in which each and every application programs can directly interact with other applications, system applications and system programs, and can directly interact with the hardware itself. So it does not break the system into subsystems and has no distinction between user and kernel modes. In previous class, when we are studying system call, you have seen that there is a different mode, like user mode and kernel mode, and we are having a flag which is called mode bit. When mode bit was one, that means we are in a user mode. When mode bit was zero, that signifies that we are currently in the kernel mode. And why there is a distinct bifurcation of user mode and kernel mode? To make the system secure so that all the non-essential things can be done in the user mode only, and all the essential things can be done in the kernel mode, which needs the services of the hardware. So this is the structure of a simple operating system, how these application programs, resident system programs, MS-DOS device drivers can directly interact with the hardware. Let's have a traditional Unix system structure. The original Unix operating system used a simple layered approach, but almost all the operating system was in one big layer, not really breaking the operating system down into layered subsystems. So this is somewhat an example of a simple structure of an operating system. Let's see what is the structure of this Unix system structure. As in this diagram, you can see that the users at the top of the hierarchy that can interact with the shells and commands, compilers and interpreters, system libraries. These are the application programs which, through which the user can interact with the hardware. And when we are having a system call interface to the kernel, but all these things are embedded in one big system, as you can see, but almost all the operating system was in one big layer, not really breaking the operating system down into layered subsystem. Means all the essential and non-essential things, each and everything is taken care by this kernel. So they are in one big layer. So it can be think of a system just like a simple structure of an operating system. As you can see, that kernel is taking care of signal terminals, handling character input output system, terminal drivers, file system, swapping block input output system, disk and tape drivers, CPU scheduling, page replacement, demand paging, virtual memory. What all these page replacement, demand paging, virtual memory, these all are comes under the memory management thing. And what is the CPU scheduling? This comes under process management. And this, what are these file systems, swapping block, input output system, disk and tape drivers? All these things comes into the input output input output system management, input output device management, and signal terminal handling, character input output system, terminal drivers, it comes under the communication. So here kernel interface to the hardware, and all the terminal controllers, terminals, device drivers, controller, disk and tapes, memory controller, physical memory, that can interact all the application programs directly. So this is the traditional Unix system structure, where the original Unix operating system used a simple layered approach. As you can see, that almost all the essential and non-essential things comes under the one big layer, and we can signify that one big layer as a kernel of that operating system. This is not really denoted as a kernel previously, but we can identify that all these things are in one big layer, and it can be treated as a kernel of that operating system. So this is the simple structure. Let's move on. Next one, that is layered approach. What is a layered approach? Again, we can have some analogy with the university system. Suppose the top of the hierarchy of university system is the chancellor. Who is the chancellor of University of Lucknow? Can anyone tell me? Who is the chancellor of University of Lucknow? Please write in the chat.
Steven Patel.
Who?
Please write Patel.
Beta, she is the honorable governor of Uttar Pradesh. Please take her name with dignity, right? Governor of Uttar Pradesh. She is the governor of Uttar Pradesh, and we are called honorable governor, right? So take her name properly. She is a very senior person also, right? She is not your friend that you can take her name directly. Understand? So show some manners, because manners make the man. Understand? And in Hindi, what we call Mahamahim. Understand? We are talking about someone, a big personality. He is the first person of the Uttar Pradesh. He is the governor of Uttar Pradesh. Just like the first person of India. Who is the first person of India? Denoted as the president of India. Understand? So please understand that we have to give respect to our these noble persons. Understand? So chancellor of a university is governor of Uttar Pradesh, right? Then who is the biggest authority after that? Vice chancellor, right? Then after that, dean of faculty, right? Suppose faculty of engineering, who is the dean? Professor R.S. Gupta, sir. He is the dean of the faculty of engineering. Then below him, who are the head of departments, right? Then below that head of departments, we are having some, suppose we are having mentors or we are having teachers, right? So what you are seeing here, there is a layer, there is a hierarchy, and each and every layer and hierarchy is having some specific functions, right? And they are providing some specific services to whom? They are providing services to students only, right? Because university system is a student-centric system. Without students, there is nothing like any institution, educational institution. So each and every hierarchy, each and every person sitting out there in an university system is helping out their students so that they can learn each and everything what they are supposed to learn here, right? And facilitate their learning environment, providing them such an environment so that they can learn properly in a peaceful manner. So this is how you can analog have an analogy with the operating system, that who is the end user, that the normal users, suppose you are students or anyone else who is using the computer system, these are the end user of that system, and how we are using, we are going to facilitate those end users. We have some specific roles and functions of each layer, that on the top of we are having some layer that taken care of some things, then we are having sub layer that can take care of some more functionalities, then we have some specific to do some specific purpose, we are having some office superintendent also, right? If you need some office help, then we are having some special device drivers like office superintendent. Have an analogy only, then you can relate, because in computer science everything is intangible. So without imagination, you cannot understand how each and everything is working in a computer system. Here in computer system environment, each and everything is intangible. You cannot understand this computer science thing without having an imagination power. So that is why I'm giving you an analogy, so that you can relate the real world environment with this virtual environment, because this virtual environment is having an inspiration from the real world only. Without inspiration, we cannot have these kinds of things. And who is the inspiration of human beings to design all these things? This is the Mother Nature. So nature has provided each and everything in out there in the world, and we humans are mimicking those things and designing those things as per our needs. So what we have understand, what is the meaning of layer? Layered system is very specific and provided some functionalities that can help end user in a proper manner. But there is also a drawback. Suppose you have some requirement, you want to talk to the vice chancellor for some issue, but you have to follow the hierarchy. Firstly, you have to meet to the class teacher with your problems, with your application. Suppose you are having some short attendance and you want to give the exam. Suppose you are having some issues in your house, there is some casualty, blah, 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 any particular issue, and you are having very below 60% attendance, still you want to give your examination, but as per our rules, you cannot give your examination. But you still hope that if our top hierarchy is the vice chancellor, if he allows me so that I can give my examination and my semester can be saved. So, but you cannot directly approach to the vice chancellor. You have to first approach to your class teacher. You have to first approach, after that, your mentor of the class, then your head of department, he will forward to your dean of faculty, then dean will forward your application to the appropriate authority in the vice chancellor office, then that entity will forward your application to the vice chancellor. Suppose vice chancellor approved or disapproved your request based upon your merit of the application, he will then revert that application to whom? To office representative of this vice chancellor, then that office representative, or we can say a personal assistant, that will forward your application to whom? To the dean of the faculty of engineering, then dean will forward that application's reply to head of department, then head of department will forward to the mentor, then mentor will forward to the class teacher, then class teacher will forward this application to that particular student who is requesting for relaxation in his or her attendance. Now, what you have seen that due to a lot of layer in between the hardware and the user program, we have some slow processing, right? Suppose one day taken by head of department, one day taken by dean of faculty,